no physics research, no physics internships. And that's why I can proudly say you don't need those. I released my own EP. College applications are all about marketing.
Hi everyone, today I'm super excited to interview one of my best friends, Minal, a musical genius and a physics prodigy, and a proud student of Cornell University. Minal, would you like to introduce yourself?
Hi everyone, I'm Minal and I'm an incoming freshman at Cornell Arts and Sciences.
Perfect. So in this video, we'll cover all five parts of your Common application so that everyone can see what a successful Ivy League application looks like. But just before that, let's zoom out a little bit. Out of all the other Ivy League schools, why did you choose Cornell?
I was tempted by the ice cream making class. I'm kidding. They have an amazing physics department and I just fell in love with their astronomy department. That's all.
Wow, that's awesome. And the ice cream making thing is a real bug. Also, Cornell is just gorgeous. I'll put some pictures on the screen here. I honestly can't wait to come visit. Second question of our Zoom Out segment. What is the one thing that you think admissions officers would have remembered about your application after reading it? What do you think stood out to them the most?
That I did a lot of things. I wasn't very smart about them, but I loved everything. So, I did it out of my heart.
Perfect. So that's actually a great point for our viewers. You don't necessarily need to have a traditional spike to get into an Ivy League university or a top 10 university. As long as you're passionate about everything that you're doing, don't worry if it's not aligned towards one field or if it's not specific to the major that you want to pursue. So now let's get into your application to Cornell in the different segments of that. So first thing, what did you apply for at Cornell?
My intended major is physics and I also put astronomy, but you can't double major in them.
And since Cornell is a liberal arts school, are there any other minors that you put on your application?
Math and music.
Wow, that's a fantastic combination. Now, jumping into the academics portion of the application, can you tell everyone what curriculum you did and what kinds of grades you got at school, all that good stuff?
For 9th and 10th, I did ICSE and I continued with the 11th and 12th version, ISC. My 10th percentage was 97.6. 11th was 84.3 and 12th, I don't know because boards are canceled.
That's literally wow. Anyone watching this is going to be like, how did you do that? Now, out of the blue, if you had to give your one best study tip, what would it be?
Please don't leave everything for the last day like I did.
Knowing you, I can confidently say that that's a humble brag. And from my perspective, it was a combination of hard work in taking really, really good notes in class and then using them to revise very efficiently. Now, getting into standardized testing, did you take the SAT or the ACT and what did you get? And did you do subject tests before they were canceled?
I did the SAT twice, once in October 2019, where I got 1500. 800 in math and 700 in English, and I did it again in December to get a 1520, a 780 in math, and a 740 in English. And I did the subject SATs. I did math 2, 800, and physics 800.
Wow. You know, one of the things that I like to point out is that everyone thinks that you need to have a 1550 plus to get into an Ivy League school. That's not necessarily true. You know, you had a great score, 1520 and a 1500 is amazing. And I think that if you get that much, there's not really much point in taking the SAT again and again and again. Now getting into AP exams, how many did you take and what scores did you get? And would you actually recommend them to anyone else applying from India?
The APs, I only took them because I wasn't really happy with my 11th scores and I needed a way to say, yes, I do know my math and I do know my physics. And I wanted to get a little bit of extra credit because ICSE isn't actually a recognized curriculum in the US. Mm-hmm. So I did 4 APs, Calculus AB, Physics 1, Physics 2, and Computer Science A. And I got 5 in all of them.
Wow. And I think that's also a really great point. You know, I get a lot of messages from people saying, I didn't do well in 9th or 10th or 11th or even 12th. And can I still get into an Ivy League university? And the answer is yes. You know, APs are a really great tool that you have. You can just take a certain number of AP exams and get really strong scores. And that immediately tells the admissions officers that you're really good at that subject. Great. So now coming to my favorite part of the application, what were some of the extracurriculars that you did and how did you find and develop them?
Big chunk of my application was just music. I actually didn't have anything related to my intended major, except like a little bit of STEM outreach. No physics research, no physics internships. And that's why I can proudly say you don't need those. You just need stuff that you're passionate about in high school and you can figure it out later in college. My main EC was piano. I've been playing for 13 years and I recently completed grade 7 of the Trinity curriculum. And I also put in music composition. I made music for a couple of organizations for a school event, and I released my own EP under the name Minus as Theorize last year, which was pretty fun.
Wow. I'll link that in the description for all those of you who want to go check that out on Spotify.
Yes, thank you. And I also played in a band in 10th grade and 11th grade, which was fun.
No, I think that's amazing. It shows so much commitment and so much dedication to one particular thing. And even though that's not the thing that you want to major in college, I think it's so helpful on your application to show that you're committed to something. You know, whether that's something creative or a sport or a job. I think commitment in any form is a really valuable quality. So what were some of the other things you did besides music? Because as I remember, your application was actually quite diverse and you put a number of different things that you tried throughout your 4 years of high school.
I actually taught with Nitya under Vidyaverse, where we went around to schools teaching science and math to underprivileged children. And that was really fun, like making up the experiments and teaching them to fun little kids. I ran a little blog. I don't update it much, but it's there. It's called Notes to a Beloved, where I put up poetry and essays that I don't get to show anywhere else. Mm-hmm. And I wrote for the school newspaper.
That's a big one. You know, you can also mention the National Linguistics Olympiad that we participated in. I'll link that down below in case anyone wants to look that up. And the research project that we're supposed to be working on right now.
We should really get on with it.
So basically, that's about sort of building a program to identify media bias. But my point being that we had some very similar activities, but we were applying for two very different majors. And I think it's all about how you pitch the activities that you did to the field of study that you're interested in.
Yes, marketing is a big part of it.
Mm-hmm, definitely. And that's a perfect segue into my next question. You know, what did you write about in your Common App essay? How did you market yourself to these universities?
My essay was a bit of a rush job. I didn't get, like, I wrote many drafts, but the draft I ended up going with was a bit last minute. And it was a bit simple. I wrote for the first prompt. I believe you wrote for the same thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
The identity interest. Yep. Yes. So I used notebooks as a window into my life because I collect notebooks. And I wrote about the different kinds of notebooks that I use for the different activities that I do in my life.
Wow, honestly, that's such a beautiful idea. And I've read your essay and I think it was a perfect combination of your experiences and your personality and your interests. And I think that this is the kind of essay that an admissions officer would remember even after they'd finished reading it. It was so genuine, so heartfelt. I'm honestly a little bit in awe of your essay. I will link it down below for anyone who wants to read it. It's on Minul's blog. Go check it out.
Simple ideas really can work well.
Yeah.
You don't have to have a complex, high and mighty line to start your essay.
Yeah.
Just notebooks will do.
That great advice. I think a lot of people really stress about finding the most like fancy or unique topic. And I think, you know, just go with the simple ideas. Just go with what you feel is best. And another thing I want to ask you, because I have read your Y. Cornell essay, and it's one of the best pieces of writing I've ever seen. It was just a standout. And so do you have any tips for anyone who's writing a Y school essay right now? Which hopefully they are, because you should be writing your essays the summer before 12th grade.
Research. Know your school like the back of your hand. Like, research really helps. And these schools really know if you're passionate about them and you really did your homework on what they're looking for. And I did a lot of research for my Cornell essay, which is why I couldn't write it very quickly. But it really helps to be specific about what you want, what you're looking for, and how the school is going to give it to you.
Mm-hmm. So can you give us sort of an example of something that you were specific about in your essay?
I wrote about astronomy.
Wow.
And physics and how my background in computer science can help me. since I didn't have any like direct physics research background and I wasn't gonna start anytime soon, I had to like be a little creative, make connections.
That's such a good point. And I also remember a segment in your essay about stargazing and how Cornell has these beautiful telescopes in clear skies, which you don't get here living in a big city. And I think even the point about being a little creative with your extracurriculars, you know, even for me, I was applying for computer science and I didn't have any computer science related activities. So I had to pitch sort of my art skills and my, you know, things with the science education program in a way that talks about why I love technology. There are no limits except how creative you can get with the things that you've done and how you can market them in your own words.
Yeah, make unconventional connections, and admissions officers are really gonna like that. And especially if you're writing for arts and sciences, they like a little bit of variety.
Yeah, you know, any person, any study, right? That's the Cornell motto. So that leads perfectly into my last question. What is one piece of advice you have for anyone applying to college right now, or for your younger self? What is something that you think they should know?
I know college application season's gonna make you severely doubt yourself and think you're not good enough, but never believe that, and don't sell yourself short. College applications are all about marketing. Package yourself well enough and you'll get anywhere.
Thank you so much for doing this. You know, I think there's so much that people can learn by looking at your successful application and from your advice. I'm honestly inspired by that application because it was so good. Are there any last pieces of advice and any last words you have for our audience?
Like, share, and subscribe. I'm so happy to be on Nithya's channel. It's like my own 15 minutes of fame. And I know you're doing a great job to get these people into their dream colleges. And I really admire that. And I'm happy to be a part of that story.
Thank you. This is honestly so sweet. I hope you all enjoyed this video. I hope you all learned something. If you did, like, share, subscribe, comment any questions you have below. I respond to all comments. And hopefully we'll have Lil back for another video. If you guys enjoyed this one, y'all can start a petition in the comments. Thank you for watching, have a great day, and I'll see you soon.
Go big red!